Now in this video, we're going to take a look at a couple of special features within Safari that can help make reading articles a little bit easier. We have a reading list, like a temporary bookmark, and then we also have Reader View, which takes out all of the ads and things like that. Makes an article a bit easier to read. Now before we get started, if you like what you see here, stick around to the end. I'll tell you a little bit more about myself and how you can help support my efforts in creating these videos. All right, let's get back to Safari on the iPhone. Let's first take a look at the reading list. This is like a temporary bookmark. When we go and add a bookmark, let's say I wanted to add this as a bookmark. So I tap on it, and then we go down here to share. And then from here, I can add it as a bookmark. When I do that, what it does is it saves it permanently within my bookmarks. So once I read it, it's still going to be in my bookmarks. It's not going to remove it. Well, the reading list is like a temporary bookmark. So basically what it'll do is it'll add it to the reading list, but then once you read it from the reading list, it'll remove it from that reading list. So it'll remove it automatically because you've already read the article. So it doesn't necessarily save it permanently. So essentially what you're able to do is go through a website and select which articles you want to read, add them to the reading list, and then you can go to that reading list at a later date and read all those articles. And it doesn't have to be from one website, it could be from multiple websites. So as an example, let's say I wanted to add this to my reading list. All I have to do is just tap on the share icon, and then I just swipe up a little bit to get to add to reading list. I tap on it, and it'll add it to that reading list. Let's go and add a couple more. So I'm going to go back, and let's just go with this one here. I want to add that to my reading list. I'll show you a little shortcut. Remember how we have a contextual menu, or maybe you don't know that we have a contextual menu? You long press on this link, and when I do, I get a contextual menu that pops up, and one of the options here is add to reading list. Maybe a little hard to get to, so you just swipe up a little bit, and then you can tap on add reading list, and it'll add that to the reading list. Let's go to a different website. I'm just going to swipe to go to a different tab. So I just swipe down there. I'm looking at Wikipedia here. What I would like to do is bookmark that, or actually add it to my reading list. I'm not going to bookmark it. I'm going to add it to the reading list. So I just long press on it, swipe up a little bit, add to reading list. And let's just go with one more. We're going to go with this one here. Long press, add to reading list. So now we've just added those articles to my reading list. Now what I would like to do is I would like to read this. Well, all we have to do is just go over to our little book here. This is where we can find our history and our bookmarks. But in addition to that, when we go in the middle tab here, we have our reading list. So the last article I looked at was on prostate cancer. I swipe up. These are the two articles that I added earlier. So now if I want to read these, all I have to do is just tap on it. So I just tap on this one here. And the nice thing about this is this reading list will sync across all your different devices. So you can go to your iPad or your Mac and then find the same reading list. All right, so let's just go ahead and tap on this and see how we read it. So I tap on it, it opens it up, and now I can read that article. So I just swipe up until I read it. Now this is the beauty of the reading list. First of all, it stores it offline. I just recently used this on a trip. I was on the airplane and it didn't have any Wi-Fi. I went with a low budget airline and I couldn't get on Wi-Fi. So how did I read my reading list? Well, when you go into the reading list here, when you tap on the reading list, it does store it on the device. So you don't have to worry about being on the internet. It stores it on device. All right, so I just go down to the bottom. I'm reading this article. And now when I get down to the very bottom, what you're going to see is up next. All I have to do is just swipe up, continue to swipe up, and it takes me to the next article. So again, I can read this article here. And when I am done, you're going to see it's going to go to my next article, the one from CNN. So now I just swipe up. Try it again. Might have to do that a couple times. Now I'm looking at that article. So you can easily go through and read all of your articles in the reading list just by swiping there. Now remember how I mentioned it's a temporary bookmark? It removes it once you've read it. So I've read those three articles, right? So now let's go back over to my reading list. So I'm going to swipe down here, and what we're going to do is tap on the little book icon here. And when I do, you're going to see that I only have one CNN article. Remember, I added two CNN articles, so this is one of them that I added because I haven't read it. But the other one I did read, and I had those two Wikipedia articles. They are no longer in here. So it's just removing them as I read them. Now, what we're able to do is view all of our pages. So if I wanted to see all those, I could do that as well. I tap on Show All, and there's all the articles again. So you could go and view all of the articles if you want. When you do that, you're going to see that this changes to Show Unread. Now I just want to see my unread articles. I tap on that, and now it's back to my unread articles. So I can tap on this, and then when I get to the bottom, what it'll do is it'll go to this one, and when I get to the bottom, it'll go to this one here. And what it'll also do is remove these as I'm reading them. You can also search your reading list. To do that, what you do is you just go up to the top here, and if you don't see that, sometimes what you may need to do is just swipe down a little bit. Sometimes that is hidden, but you can search your reading list here. And then if you want to edit it, you can do that as well. You tap on Edit, and then from here you're able to select which ones you want to remove, and you can remove them permanently from your reading list. So as you can see, it's almost like a bookmark, but I call it a temporary bookmark folder. When you add something to the reading list, it'll put it in here temporarily. It'll stay there until you read it. Once you read it, what it'll do is it'll remove it. And then, of course, you can go back and see it by tapping on Show All. But basically, what you're able to do is just scroll through your iPhone and read those articles. So that's the reading list. Let's take a look at another feature on the iPhone with Safari that can help make reading articles easier. We have Reader View. So when I'm looking at an article, let's just go to this article here. I tap on it. And you can see it has ads in there. It's a little clunky to read. What I would like to do is make this a little bit easier to read. I want to strip all that out. Well, that's what Reader View does. It strips all of that out and makes things a little bit easier to read. This only works on articles, and it doesn't work on every article. But for the most part, when you're reading an article, so if you go to the CNN's homepage, it's not going to work, but if you go to an article within CNN, it will work. So I'm on an article within CNN. I want to read this in Reader View. The way that I do that is I need to show the address bar here so I don't see it. So what do? I just swipe down a little bit, and I have my address bar. And then from here, all I have to do is just long press on this little icon here. When I long press on it, just tap and hold for a little bit. What it's going to do is it's going to put this article into Reader View. And now we can see it took out all of those ads. It makes it a lot easier to read. I'm even able to make changes to this. I can change the text size. I can go and change the background. To do that, what we do is we just tap on this here. And when I do, I'm able to change the background. I'm able to change the font. I can go and change the text size. To go back to the standard view, I can tap on Hide Reader, or when you're in Reader View, I'm going to long press on this again. When I'm in Reader View, I can also just long press on this, and then what it'll do is it'll take it out of Reader View. Reader View does work with reading list. So I'm going to go back into Reader View. And remember how when you swipe up and you go to the very bottom here, when you're in the reading list, you can go to the next article. Look what shows here. I can go to the next article. So now I just swipe up, and I'm looking at the next article in Reader View. The last thing I want to show you with reading is we can have articles open up in Reader View automatically based on the website. So with CNN, what I would like to do is I would like to have all of the articles. When I go to an article, I want it to open up in Reader View automatically. But if I'm at my site, Dan's Tutorials, I don't want it to do that. So what we do is we go to the site that we want to open up an article in Reader View in. So I'm on CNN here. I'm just going to long press on this to go back into regular mode. And what I would like to do is whenever I'm in an article with CNN, I want it to open up in Reader View. Well, instead of long pressing on this, all I have to do is just tap on it. So just do a single tap. do a single tap, I get to my page view options, and then from here what we do is we go to the more. When we tap on more, what we have at the very bottom here are some options for this website. You're going to see it says website settings for CNN.com. So anything that I change in this area here is only for CNN. It's not going to be for anything else. So you're going to see one of the options here is use reader automatically. So now I tap on that, and when I open up an article, when I'm in CNN, it's going to open up in Reader View automatically. But if I'm at Yahoo or any other site, it will not do that. So let's see how that works. I'm going to go out of here, and we're going to go back out of Reader View. I'm just going to go back to the main page. You can see it's automatically opening up these articles in Reader View as I'm going back. I'm just tapping on the little history button here. So let's just go to CNN. And now what I want to do is I want to look at this article here. I tap on it, and what is it going to do? It's going to open it up in Reader View automatically. Now, if you want to view the page in regular view, you can do that. Just go to this little icon here and long press on it. It doesn't make it permanent. You can go back and open it up in regular view as well. But if I were to go to Yahoo and open up an article, it would not do that. So if I was at Yahoo, what I would do if I wanted those pages to open up in Reader View, I go to Yahoo, and now I'm on Yahoo. I tap on that. I don't long press on it. I tap on it. We go to the three dots. I swipe up, and I want Yahoo to use Reader automatically. So now I just tap on the little slider, and when I go to an article, so I'm not looking at an article here, so if I were to refresh this, it's still not going to go into Reader View. But when I open up an article, watch what happens. I'm going to go to this article here, and watch what happens. It opens up in Reader View. So that's how we can make articles a little bit easier to read and manage our reading list in Safari on the iPhone. Now, if you found this video helpful, what you may want to do is like the video. You can share it with your friends and family. You can subscribe to my channel. It all helps. But in addition to that, you may want to check out danstutorials.com. In addition to having more videos, I also have an AI assistant modeled after an Apple genius, and I host classes and webinars on a regular basis. So how can you help support my efforts? Well, it is a membership-based site. When you become a member of the site, I take out all of the ads of the videos, so you're not going to see any of those pesky ads. You have access to my AI assistant modeled after an Apple genius, and you have access to my classes and webinars. In addition to that, you're also helping support a small business. It is just me in a corner office of my house. I'm not part of some large organization. So when you become a member, you are directly supporting my efforts in creating these videos. Check out danstutorials.com for more information, and thanks for watching.